This is the award-winning Lee Pitts Live.
Brought to you by the North Law Firm. For car accidents and negligent security cases, call Joe at 239-337-1191. By Southwest Florida Crime Stoppers, where you can report crimes and get paid with nobody knowing your identity. Call 1-800-780-TIPS. By Solomon's Air Conditioning Incorporated. No matter what the weather condition is outside, have it your way inside. 239-693-1569. And by Lee Health.
Welcome back, Southwest Florida, to Lee Pitts Live. We're so thrilled that you stayed with us. We're here at the fire department. Great accommodations as we close out our stay here. It's been such a fabulous occasion. We're so thrilled to do a show that I've been looking forward to doing, and that's to discuss AIDS Healthcare Foundation and get to find out about a lot of things that are happening in society, especially if you have a compromised immune system that all of us are starting to say these words second nature now. But this organization has been around a long time, helping people to get on to safety and to improve their health. So without further ado, we're welcoming here to the studio my good friend Amy Pinter. Amy, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me back.
It's and for the first time, we got Ebony here, Ebony Crispin. Welcome to Lee Pitts Live.
Thank you for having me.
And hopefully, this won't be your last time checking us out.
Yes, sir.
All right. I got something for you guys. I got a gift. Falls right under safety. Attorney Joe North is passing out these free masks. You can hold that up that everybody can stay safe. Shout out to Attorney Joe North. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Now, I would assume, Amy, that when somebody is handing out masks, going around just giving people masks, that's something that you would applaud, huh?
Absolutely, I would, yes.
Why is that?
I think it's important right now that everybody wears a mask. Mm-hmm. And I'm seeing way too many people still not wearing masks or wearing them incorrectly.
Amen. How about you, Ebony?
Same. I think regardless of whether you do have a compromised immune system or not, it's important for us to remember that you don't know how your body will respond to corona, and you don't know how other people's body will respond to corona. So I think it's a responsible decision to wear a mask.
How are you, starting with you, Ebony, how are you guys now continuing to get the education process out to the public now that we're operating in a different situation as it relates to the pandemic?
Well, you know, according to the Department of Health for the state of Florida, if you have HIV or AIDS and are taking your medication properly, you have the same opportunity to get coronavirus as anyone else. But like other compromised immune system, as you mentioned earlier, if you're not taking care of yourself, not taking the proper precautions, that can affect your health in, unfortunately, really great ways. So we think that it's very important as an organization to be as responsible as possible, both as team members, but also our clients, our community partners, et cetera.
I see. Amy, expound on some of the challenges there.
Some of the challenges during COVID?
Mm-hmm.
People don't want to wear the masks. People don't understand necessarily that this is something that can affect you, even though you might be feeling well, or as Ebony said, you could be passing on to someone else without being aware of it. We haven't seen a great impact with our patients. I was worried when I first started hearing about this that our clients with compromised immune systems would be having terrible outcomes and we'd be seeing a high mortality rate, but we haven't seen that, thank goodness. So I'm very pleased about that.
Now, at your clinic or in your space, you guys always have been practicing, you know, germ prevention and things of that nature. But do you have to ramp up certain things now to ensure additional safety?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. We're doing temperature screenings and wellness checks on all of our staff every morning, on all of our clients or anybody before they come into any of our buildings. Everyone is wearing a mask. We're doing extra cleaning. So, yes, we're doing all those sorts of things. Spacing out our appointments. We're offering telehealth and telephone visits, limiting the number of people in our buildings at any one time.
if someone is living with HIV or AIDS, they are at a higher risk, though, right?
It doesn't seem that way.
With COVID-19, that's what I mean.
It doesn't seem that way. We have not seen large numbers, and we haven't seen large numbers of our patients being infected, about the same rate as the general public, and they're doing well. None Good. Of our patients have passed away, so it doesn't seem that they're at a higher risk, and you know, maybe that's because they're taking these instructions more seriously and they're doing a better job of social distancing and wearing masks. Maybe it's because the medications are so much better now than they were, and our patients are healthier overall than they were 10 years ago. You know, we have...
That's great to hear. Go ahead.
It certainly is. The medications are so much easier to tolerate than they used to be. And we have an 87% viral suppression rate, meaning that 87% of our patients have an undetectable viral load. So their immune systems are healthier. So it doesn't... I'm not Dr. Fauci, but it certainly doesn't seem that they're at a higher risk than the general public.
Okay. What should the Fort Myers community know about testing?
Well, I think, you know, one of the important factors that I share with all of our community partners and when regional directors like Amy request that I come and chat is anytime you introduce a new sexual partner into your experience, you need to get tested. That's even more prevalent because what we do find across the state of Florida and other areas where we have healthcare centers, because people are quarantining, that doesn't necessarily mean they're not inviting people into their house to hang out, including people that may be going to a work environment or been to an event or restaurants. And so I think in that regard, we need to be more precautious and remember that even though we're quarantining, it's important to remain tested, to keep testing. And I think also what's important is that be aware of healthcare centers in your area. Here in Fort Myers, obviously, we, as an AIDS Healthcare Foundation, we have a local center. But regardless of where you choose to go, be mindful of your experience so that you know what exactly is going on for you and the people that you introduce into your life.
What are some basic tips that you would give people that you'll see when they relax sometimes to never relax?
That's a good question. I would say, first of all, I think some people still see AIDS and HIV as a gay disease.
Mm-hmm.
As a result of that, they feel like they are not susceptible to contracting HIV. When that happens, they're less likely to talk to their partner or partners. They're less likely to talk to their medical providers, ask questions, get tested. And so I think it's really important that you keep in mind that this disease, this virus, like other STIs, does not care about your sexual orientation, your race, your age. In some areas of our country, the 55-plus community has an increased case of HIV. So I just want to keep in mind that tips for people include not thinking that there's no way that you can contract HIV.
I see. What are the plans for World AIDS Day? That used to be our annual pilgrimage sort of around this time, Amy. Go ahead.
Well, it did. World AIDS Day is December 1st, and as you very well know, because you've been our media sponsor for the past few years, we've historically had a World AIDS Day in the Park event at Clemente Park, which was really a lot of fun. And it was put together in conjunction, AHF in conjunction with several other local nonprofit HIV providers in the area. Unfortunately, we had to make the difficult decision to cancel that event this year. We didn't think there was any way we could safely and responsibly do that. We will definitely be marking World AIDS Day. It's a very important day, you know, to remember those that have lost their battle against HIV and AIDS, as well as to celebrate those that are living and thriving with HIV and AIDS. We're still in the planning process. We don't know exactly what we're going to do yet, but unfortunately, it won't be the World AIDS Day in the park.
Well, I'm sure some people will be doing some virtual stuff, and we'll be updating here on Leap Is Live.
Absolutely.
Give that date again. That's December.
It's December 1st every year.
Okay, so we got a little time there. Won't put you under that pressure. The Southwest Florida, Fort Myers area in general, as it relates to Southwest Florida, Fort Myers area, does it pose any? Is it any significant uniquenesses here in terms of demographics, in terms of just in general, as it relates to HIV and AIDS, getting tested, getting contracted with the virus, and so on and so forth?
I'm not sure about the uniqueness of the area, but you know, as Ebony said, it's so important if you're sexually active to be responsible and be tested for HIV on a regular basis. It doesn't discriminate. Don't think that it can't happen to you. We do have about 2,400 people living with HIV in Lee County at
That's
the moment.
That's what I think I'm trying to get to. Yeah, are we big? Are we like low in the state of Florida? Are we a high area?
We're about 8 or 9 out of 64 counties, so that's, I think, much higher than we'd like to be, unfortunately.
Yeah, it fluctuates year to year.
So how do y'all track that? Tell me what y'all looking at when y'all tracking that. Do you like some stats go into a data bank somewhere?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so anytime anyone tests positive for HIV or AIDS, it goes to the Department of Health, which is obviously a state government, and that's where they're tracking the numbers. That's how we know that, for example, Miami-Dade is number one in the country of new cases of HIV, followed by Broward County out on the east coast of the state is number two. And so that's how Amy's able to articulate that Fort Myers or Lee County is vacillates back and forth between 8 and 9. Mm-hmm. And that changes year to year, which is another reason why people need to be not afraid, but aware. People live very long lives these days if they have HIV, but they have to know of it, obviously, and also be aware of it so they can be on top of their medication and seeing their medical provider on a regular basis, things like that.
Mm-hmm. Now, AIDS Healthcare Foundation, were you guys sort of like a pioneer? You like the early you got behind this years ago? You're sort of like the granddaddy, the grandma of them all. Kind of tell people about that unique history and how you AIDS Healthcare Foundation fits into the big picture of healthcare in the United States.
Sure. The AIDS Healthcare Foundation started as the AIDS Hospice Foundation 32 years ago, started by one man with a clipboard, Michael mm-hmm. Weinstein, who was seeing his friends dying of HIV. So, you know, several years into it, people stopped dying when the protease inhibitors came out. People stopped dying, and we went from the AIDS Hospice Foundation to the AIDS Healthcare Foundation. We are a global nonprofit organization. We're in, I lose count because we grow so quickly, 35 plus countries. We're in 16 different states, and we are the largest provider of HIV care in this country. And we do everything that we do is nonprofit, and everything that we do is related to people living with HIV and AIDS and trying to live better.
Well, it's like big celebrities like Elton John and people like that, they're kind of associated with y'all in some kind of way, don't? In terms of donations and things in the past, or do you know?
We had an association with Magic Johnson at one point in time. I'm not sure that we've had any interaction with Elton John. If you're listening, we'd love to work with you.
But I know he's out there, you mm-hmm. know, educating people.
Absolutely.
I say that, well, let me continue with you on this point. You said early on AIDS Awareness Day, AIDS Day, what's the name of the former
World
name?
AIDS Day.
World AIDS Day. That you have all these different community groups that are involved with the movement of helping people. That's nationwide. It's a lot of groups. All of you work together as partners in some kind of way? Are you competing with each other? How does that work?
Well, we have a lot of partnerships. Here locally, we partner very well with the Department of Health, with Premier Mobile, the Source of Light and Hope. You know, no one agency can do everything. We need to have partnerships. We need to be able to refer our patients when they need services that we can't provide. And unfortunately, there's enough patients to go around, so I don't like to feel that we compete. I think we do better when we work together.
Now, when one comes to your office, we have your website on the screen, but they can physically come to your office here in Fort Myers. Let's give that location and phone number, and they can certainly be assured that they will their identity and they will be anonymous kind of thing.
Oh, of course. We take confidentiality very seriously. We're at 2231 McGregor Boulevard. Our phone number is 239-337-2391. And we certainly hope that people will come by and see us and access our services. We work very hard to make people feel welcome,
good,
make sure that they're getting the services that they need and they feel comfortable receiving them.
Do they have to have an appointment?
Absolutely not.
Okay, that's great. Now, you cover a region, if I'm not mistaken, with your title. So you're moving around. Tell me the territory that you're covering.
So I am the Legislative Affairs and Communication Manager for AHF South, which covers 7 states, including Florida, Georgia, Mississippi, South Carolina, Texas. I also do work in the Caribbean islands, and we cover South countries in South America as well.
So you're doing some advocacy work there. Talk about that.
So advocacy looks like a lot of different things. Sometimes it's protesting policies statewide or federally that will not benefit our clients. We do a lot of work as it relates to housing, mm-hmm. because healthcare cannot be a siloed issue. If someone is suffering with any number of healthcare ailments, it's likely that they may have issues around housing as well. So we have to remember that these issues are intersectional. Mm-hmm. And so one of the issues that we advocate for strongly is housing, both for the homeless and those are low income, and the workforce as well. Because we have seen that if people are struggling, have fear around not being able to pay rent or not cover or not know where they're going to sleep, they're certainly not thinking about taking their HIV meds. And so our goal is to be able to help people as much as we can when we're able to, and we're not always able to, in full transparency, but to be able to advocate for issues that matter around housing as well. We also do a lot of work around racial justice. We've done a lot of work around transgender rights. Anything that supports the people that we touch the most, as just a good steward of an organization, it's important for us to be able to advocate around different matters, including healthcare, because we recognize it touches a lot of different issues.
When people hear AIDS Healthcare Foundation, what do you hope come to their mind?
That's a good question. I think one thing is that regardless of whether someone is aging or young, black, white, Hispanic, the immigrant population of any kind, that they can come to AIDS Healthcare Foundation in any of our healthcare centers, regardless of their ability to pay, their background, their path, what they've done or haven't done, what they've experienced or haven't experienced, that we are as inclusive as we possibly can. And when we aren't, we course correct. Because ultimately, it's about how do we help and support others.
Amy, one of the things I've noticed from doing various shows on AIDS Healthcare Foundation and being in some of your events is it seems this whole emphasis and importance of diversity in terms of the different range of people that you guys interface with. That's very important to your organization that you include everybody and be conscious of diversity.
Oh, absolutely. It's very important, and we can see it. You know, we interact, as Ebony said, our clients come from all different walks of life, all different backgrounds, and we want them to feel welcome. We want to understand, you know, their history and what they may have gone through before they came to us. And we recognize that diversity brings a lot to the table. You know, our staff is all different colors, sexual orientations.
Right. It seems like multilingual. People speak various languages. Go.
Absolutely. Because so many people that we work with speak various languages. So we want to be able to provide services in the language that people are comfortable with. So we try hard to have people that are multilingual. Absolutely. From
great.
All backgrounds.
Well, I like this partnership that I'm seeing here. We're practicing social distancing, so don't hit me with Twitter. And we're setting an example. They'll be putting their mask on when they leave. Well, ladies, it's been a pleasure having you both on the show. Looking forward to getting you back in the future, okay?
Absolutely.
All right, as the saying goes on this particular show, for those who say it can't be done, they're usually interrupted by those like these fine people from AIDS Healthcare Foundation, certainly here in Fort Myers, who are doing it. We'll see you next week right here on Fox 4.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, Southwest Florida. Thanks for watching Lee Pitts Live. Of course, I'm Lee Pitts. I hope you enjoy that particular show, but you can always catch us here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button down there. That way you can get your Lee Pitts Live on demand when you want it and how you want it. We also encourage you to watch our show on Fox 4 and connect with us on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live.